Hey guys, what up here, and welcome back to NASCAR 6 Total Team Control Career Mode Part 24. We got more of the same. We are nearing the final stretch of races for the Busch Series season. Our point standing situation, just about one race under Luke Trigger, maybe give or take some, but we're comfortably okay, but we can't have another horrific race. We still have to, go at 100% for this, so. And this episode, we'll do three races like usual. Maybe four, but usually it's always three. It's at Michigan, which is a power track, which, again, I'm concerned with. But I will, like usual, try my best. So we'll go into qualifying and see how the race plays out for us. Okay, I'm getting worse at these. And we lose 2,000 fans from that. And keep still hearing that lady saying, "You're a big jerk." Well, you know what? Fine, I won't do autograph sessions anymore, you bastard. I won't do anymore. I'm done. Well, turn four, it might be better than our first lap, but it's going to be not too... And actually, it might be worse. Well, if it's still seventh, then we're on the inside line. And we're on the inside line. Good. Now we just have to worry about Luke Trigger and Boyer. Mainly Luke Trigger, which I don't even know where he's at. Okay, he's fourth. On the outside line, though, so that might hurt him, which is good for us. And our teammate is 12th. Wow. So our setup, it's the same as usual. I'm just hoping this will be okay in the race. It seemed like it was pretty good in qualifying, but, who knows what the race trim will be like, so. Well, it is 10 laps. It's going to go by pretty quick. So, we'll just see how it goes. Thankfully, it put us in a respectable gear, but we're still going to have a traditionally awful start. Like, good God. Like, how far back can we go? We started 7th. And we'll lose, what, 4 spots? 5? Wow, it's so damn sad. About 6 spots we lost. That is just... God damn, he's fucking pissed. Well, there goes our race. I mean, he just straight up killed me. Like, there's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. He just killed me. Took us a little bit, but we caught up to this group of cars. Man, it's just sad how that all played out. The car is definitely not as good as I thought. I mean, the fact it took us like 2 laps just to catch up to this group of cars for 35th was pretty damn concerning. And I really don't want to finish back here because we already, 150 points to the good in the standings, but we can lose like 100 of that right here if I don't gain more spots. I don't know who it was, but I'm pretty pissed. Well, we're gaining spots. We'll pit next time by. I'm hoping we can salvage something out of this. I have no idea where Luke Trigger is. Obviously, Edwards is leading, but I don't know where the 133 car is. This track is brutal. I don't know what it is with the tires or... Almost Arca Bright right into poor Terry Cook. Alrighty, we're pitting this time. I don't know where we're going to end up finishing here. I'm a little bit concerned. We'll throw it down pit road, try to gain a little bit of on-track time there. I think we did 4 tires and fuel, and that will be it. And that's going to be a respectable pit stop. They did basically what they needed to do, but we still lost time! Like, Kenseth, I was in front of him, and oh my god. Man, this has been a rough race. I don't even have any words to say. And we're going to have a horrible outlap because our gear ratio is just trash, and... Oh my god, don't tell me we're going to cycle out worse than where we did before we pitted. I'm going to be even more pissed off if that's the case. I don't know who the fuck hit me, but they're going to die the next time I find out who the hell it was. Looks like we're going to cycle out right around 29th, I think, so. See, that 56 will probably pass as he's leaving pit road, so I'll probably be for like 28th. But man, what a did he gain speed by going sideways? What is that? And there is a lot of salty people in front of me. That Watkins Glen incident just... I made a lot of enemies. And I'm sorry. Oh my god, that's not going to make our favors any better by provoking a damn rival. Okay, he was going to hit me anyways. Okay, we're good. Alright. Well, as long as we get by this 120 car, then we'll be good of rivals and... Maybe we can salvage something out of it, but we gotta get by him first. And we do. Alright, and we're gonna probably get up to 20th as we get past that 184 or whatever his number is. So. Hooray, I guess. Oh, that's Luke Trigger right there. I thought that was Tony Stewart. Oh my God, he's having a bad day. As well as Boyer. Oh, we're not. We're, I'm having a stroke. I was so excited. And we're just. Are we going to pass him on the outside on NASCAR 06? What universe is this? 2020 has been weird, but I don't even have any words. We just straight up passed him. Trying to keep the car on the bottom. Man, it's just such a shame. I think we definitely could have had a top 10 car at least in that lap. One or two incident just killed us. And does seem like we're going to maybe salvage a top 15 somehow. And we're going to gain points on Luke Trigger and Boyer, which I didn't even think was going to be a factor. And yet somehow I overcame all those obstacles. And got to keep that car pinned to the bottom, because as you see, the car just skates up the track there in 1 and 2. Mayfield, if that's him, don't block me. I'm going to need an arc into the corner a little bit. Thank you. Okay, well, through 3 and 4, Carl Edwards is going to win. It's not going to matter for us, but we'll bring it home 14th, maybe 13th as we get by Yaley. No, I'll take 14th. After the race I had, that is a win in my book. We'll take a look at the finishing results. Top 10's pretty standard. So that was the 86 that destroyed me? We gotta look at the race reel, because for once it actually shows things that I want to actually see. And if I find out it's that 86, the next time I see him, I will door slam the ever-living shit at him, sacrificing my entire race just to get back at him, because that's what he did to me. Okay, here we go. What? God damn it. It showed the proper replay angle once, and now I gotta go through the whole thing again just to see it. Okay. It was the 86. Okay. Next time I find him, I will sacrifice my race, my life, to get back at him. Because that boned me. Not as bad as I thought, but we gonna have fucking beef. I'm really interested to see the point standings. We actually did gain points. I think Shane Neal, Labonte, they probably close in, but again, they're so far back, it doesn't really matter. But yeah, we somehow, some way gained. So I will gladly take that as a win in my book, and we'll move on to the next race, which I don't remember what it was. That's gonna be Bristol. Okay, well, that should go well, I hope. Through 3 and 4 on our first lap, that honestly felt like a pull lap. And it was. We didn't even scrape the wall, but it still didn't matter. 15-2. Oh, damn, we got it by about 2/10. This might be a dominating race, which, you know, for once I will take. We gotta execute. So our setup is the same as it was in spring. I think I changed the rear end ratio on the gears, just to help us out a little bit. Otherwise, everything else remained untouched. So, we should do well as long as, you know, the race just plays out. Like to just have a race where we just destroy the field. And classically, we are in third gear. I should have downshifted into second, but Edwards is going to take the lead. We don't kill someone on lap one, so that's also nice. But lap's not over yet, so it still could happen, but no, it doesn't. Okay. And we'll actually reclaim the lead. Wow. All right, well, that's nice. I'm going to be pinned this lap. We're still leading, but only by about 2/10, so it's really not anything too crazy in terms of the gap. I thought it would be a lot more. Bull pit here. I obviously could have angled that pit stop entry a little bit better, but whatever. Hello, Vickers. Okay. Four tires and fuel. We'll lower that wedge, and that's it. Of course. Of course, we just can't have a race. Just we can't win. Like, it... We have to have something go wrong, and it's frustrating, because like, we should have had so many more wins this season, but our pit crew chokes it, and you see Vickers way out there in front of us, and yeah, well, we just gave up the win because of that. So thank you, pit crew, for choking another race win away. And we lost like 3 seconds on pit road. Edwards took over the lead. I thought Vickers would have for sure had it, but nope, and there's no real way we're going to gain that amount of time, so great. That's just fucking wonderful. Again, we just lose another race by something out of my control. Closing in on Kyle Busch, but I don't really know if we'll have enough time to get by him. Or, again, we gain like half a second on Edwards, but again, it's just clearly not enough. I think, obviously, fourth or fifth is all we can really get. Which, we did lead the most laps, so at least I think so. I'm not really sure, but I think that's Trigger in second, I think. So we might lose some points, but I don't think a whole lot. It's just, I don't even have, I'm just very, very dejected after all that. It's just, we clearly had the car to win, and we just, our picker just can't execute, and it just pisses me off. And I feel like the Cup Series is going to be kind of like that same struggle as well, so, I don't know. At least we have a top five, so I guess there's that. Alright, I have no worries, I'm just disappointed. Okay, that was Stewart, not Luke, so... Still, we'll gain points on second and third, so... Which is really nice. And, okay, we led about the same as Edwards, so we'll get 165 points. Luke is... Where is he gonna finish? Okay, he got 14th. We got 165, so we gained about 44 points on him, which is good. And we'll move on to the next race. I don't want to say anything because like I don't want to complain, but I do that so much. But it's just it sucks so much. Is a rival gonna beat my ass? Is that the 86 car? I don't know. But what kind of case argument could he have? Well, then again, I did destroy the whole field at Watkins Glen, so I guess that's a valid reason for it. Let me guess. One of them is gonna be about getting a raise. Yes, it is. Well, I appreciate that. Another one is about an angry driver, so... Damn it, I apologized. I wanted to confront him. I wanted to provoke him. Damn. Last race for the episode is at New Hampshire, I think? No, it's California. Oh my god. Oh, we are gonna suck. We're gonna lose points there for sure. I'm glad we gained what we did at Bristol, because we're gonna probably lose all that and more after California. Are we really going to get the pole? We did. At a track, I really didn't think we would do really anything. We got it by about a tenth, but still a pole nonetheless. I'm shocked. I'm sure in race trim we'll be like shit, but it's nice to have that false sense of hope. We're on the pole, and here's our custom setup stuff. Same as usual, I did. The only thing I did change was the 3-to-1 ratio. I bumped that down a little bit. It does seem like it helps out a lot, just gives a little more top-end speed. So I think that's probably what saved us from being not trash in the straightaways. So. Also, it seems like the assists, in terms of like how it breaks, it slows you down, varies from track to track. Because here was pretty gradual, another track is very like abrupt. But like usual, we'll have a horrible start. That's nothing really new. Poor Battle of Bonnie's getting the worst end of it. But it seems like we're getting up to speed. At least doesn't take us a full lap. It was about two corners, so that's honestly a lot better than normal. And we're still in the top 10, which is nice. And we just got to make sure, because if that 83, I see him back there. He's in like seventh, so we got to run away from him. If he does anything to me, I will make sure to go out of my way to destroy him in this race. But he hasn't caught me yet, so we just are gonna race like normal for now. And now we just cracked up inside the top five. And we're going to the inside of... Ooh, that was almost death. Can we get to the inside of Edwards for fourth? Or are we going to go three wide? Or this is like a Wi-Fi bar four wide for a second there. That was weird. Okay, can we get everything situated yet? Edwards and Luke. Okay, it looks like we are. We'll get a draft from Shane Neal. Isn't that cute? Shane Neal wins here once in the Truck Series, and now he's just, you know, the god of California. Isn't that cute? Reminds me of the Heat games. But yeah, we'll take over second, and now we'll just set our sights on the leader. The fact I'm saying that here at this track, of all places, is still really weird. And it's cute, as soon as I go up the track and slide up, he blocks me. For no good reason. We just straight up stuck the bottom here. We're going for the lead. It's like a nice feeling, but at the same time, I just know my picker are going to screw it up. They're going to ruin it. So the only thing I can do now is just build up a stupid gap. But I don't think we can gain like a 4-second buffer before a pit stop. So it's, again, just false hope. And I choked the corner. And am I going to lose the lead to Shane Neal? Am I clear of Shane Neal or... Okay, we're clear, but barely. It's like I just don't feel like winning. Like, my car just does things to just jeopardize my chances to do well. As we gave up the lead. Competent straightaway speed, I'll say that much. But we'll lose it here. Now we gotta try to get that spot back. And on to the okay, we good. A little scary, but okay, we're still good. That was a little concerning. Wow, I have no words. I just straight up just forgot how to turn. I don't know what I don't. I have no excuse. That was just bad. We're gonna pit this lap. I don't know. I mean, we're doing pretty decent. But I'm just concerned. I just know Pick was going to screw it up. But, oh, they're actually slowing down a lot more than I thought. Maybe they slowed down enough. Okay, we're good. Okay, okay. That. I thought we were good, and then it wasn't. Oh my fucking god. We are just destined to not win anymore for the rest of the season. Did he really? Did we? Oh my god. Did he seriously took the... Oh my god! Did he seriously just take the time to, like, adjust his visor? For what? Why? Get off my side! Let's just break down what the hell just happened. So my pit crew made a blunder. So the stop was just, in general, slow. And then, once this, pit stop was finished, my AI driver just sat there for, like, 2 seconds, chilling. And we're gonna cycle out 31st? 30th? We lost 27 spots under pit stops. Pit stop, plural, singular. Oh my god! We cycled out 31st when we were running like third. If I title this the 28 lost pit stop or whatever I'm gonna title it, people are gonna think I'm clickbaiting. I wish I was. I wish I could clickbait something that dumb. But that's what happened. I mean, sure, maybe some gained a little bit because they did undercut me, but not 27 plus spots worthy. Oh my god, and our race is done. I mean, at least I'm gaining these spots back, but we're definitely not going to get back to where we were. It always seems like when we have a horrible pit stop, we always finish like 15th. So maybe we'll somehow do that in the next 3 laps. I don't know. We'll get by those two when we're south of the 22nd, 21st, and 23rd right in front of me. If we're only getting like 3 spots a lap, that's almost quite conveniently right at 15th. So it might still actually happen. The dream still could be real. Block it up. Oh my god, it's so... Man, just for 20th. We gonna block for 20th. I think I see the 86 car, but I'm not going to waste my damn time on him. I got to get up to the front and gain as much spots as I can and kind of stop the bleeding from all the nonsense that I just had to endure, and we're 15th, so. Okay, we actually are going to probably... Carlo? Man, this is such a shame. Like, we should have finished top 10 easily. Then again, 13th, Kenny Walls is 10th, so we could still maybe salvage it. And also Luke Trigger's 10th, or leading. Go figure. Damn, it's just so disappointing. However, top 10 is surprisingly a possibility as we'll get by Aaron Crocker, and Kenny Wallace is up there. No, it's not. It's going to be 3 wide for 10th, and I'm going to get 12th, so. No, 11th. Yeah, Aaron Crocker stopped right at the line, so thank you. Damn, we're gonna lose I don't know how many points. At least 50, I think. God, it's just unreal, the pit crew. The botchery of the pit crew is astounding this season. So Luke Trigger led 2 laps, 185 points. Shane Hill did lead the most laps. Did I lead the most? Did we tie? No, we didn't. So 134. So 185, 134. So yeah, we lost 51 points. A hell of a pill to swallow, but thankfully we have a good enough gap, but oh my god, that fucking sucks. I have no words. Why is my pit crew mad? I'm the one that should be, I don't know, whatever. Oh, don't tell me if the Busch Series is going to Vegas. Okay, it's Richmond. We might actually do well there. So next episode, we'll tackle Richmond. I guess Kansas, then Lowe's. Okay, well, they might do okay in some of those. 163, so we're almost back to where we were when the race started, but with Luke's win there, we lost a big chunk of points, and we're still almost one race to the good in terms of the point lead. So, I mean, I thought I would just, like, take off in the standings, but it's not quite the case, so I'm actually, you know, having to struggle a little bit. Not at my expense, more or less my pit crew, but, yeah. Let's wrap this part up before, I'm depressed. That race, oh god, that's so disappointing. A big shout out to my 2-3 Patreon supporters, Adele Reynolds, Weather Bros, Kamikaze Games, Ryan Lazar, and Dave, our Champ 15, NASCAR Raceway.org, Billy Carrier, Drew, Jonathan Card, Robert Dillon, Golfie 100, and Danny Hammond, Ultimate Fan for a donation again. I can't thank you guys enough for your contribution and support to the channel every single month like this. It does mean a lot, and I'm always really thankful for what you guys do and contribute all, like this all the time. It's really, really incredible, and I'm always just in debt to your kindness. I'll see you all next part where we have, like, what, 7 more races? 8 more races left to go in the season, so I think part 26 or 27 might be the finale of the Busch Series season, which is pretty nice. Then we can move on to Cup and probably spend 36 parts of that, because I just can't imagine we'll win the first, that season. Now, I did get a comment saying somebody said that, they had the same thing happen to them. The similar thing happened to them as I'm dealing with now, where I'm not getting any offers for Cup. But then when that guy did, when he won the Busch Championship, he got, like, the 36 team. So we can look at the teams, because by team, this is an indication of, like, the star ratings. So I don't know what the star rank for that 36 car is. But I'm hoping it's not a trash team. I have no idea. Boris Sed's there, but I don't know what... can't remember what team it even is. I don't know. I have no idea. It's gotta be like a 2 or 3 star, which if it's 3, then maybe we can pull something off, because that's, I think, where our Busch car is right now. No, it's, I don't know. I have no idea what it is. Team Prestige is like a 5. I think it was like a 4 or something. So maybe it's not good enough. I don't know. But I don't know what the 36 car would be. I think Bohr said retired at some point, so I can't remember what team it was. I know it's not Haas. So it's got to be 2 or 3 star team. So that's going to concern me. So yeah, probably 36 more parts after the Busch. So that's sad. Yeah. Well, I guess that'll do it for me. I'll see you all later. And as always, have a good day, everyone.